فتمسكي بعراه كي لا نغرقا.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear respected brothers, alhamdulillah, welcome back to the grand finale of Q Factor season 4, alhamdulillah, for the younger age group. Just before the break, we had Tahmid Rahman, 10-year-old Tahmid Rahman, recite very beautifully the portions of the Quran and also give his speech very, very eloquently and beautifully delivered as well, alhamdulillah. Now, our next contestant, inshallah, also from London, is 9-year-old Khadija Fatima Ali. So, if I can ask Khadija to come to the stage, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah, Khadija. How are you today?
Alhamdulillah, I'm fine.
Yeah, what do you think of the contestants that have come before you? How good were they?
They're really good.
They're good? Yeah, how do you feel though? You feel confident today?
Inshallah.
Inshallah, excellent, alhamdulillah. Okay, Khadija, when you're ready, inshallah, you can begin your first recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فارجع البصر هل ترى من فطور ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر بصر خاسئا وهو حسير ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين وأعتدنا لهم عذاب السعير صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Beautifully done there, Khadija. Now if you'd like to give us the translation for that section as well.
I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed shaitan. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Most exalted is the being in whose control is all of the kingdom and who has power over everything. He has created death and life. لِيَبَلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا To test which of you carry out the best acts. He is the mighty, the most forgiving. He has created the seven heavens in layers. You will not see any defects in Allah's creation. فَرُجِعِ الْبَصَرُ Look again. هَلْ تَرَى مِنْ فُطُورِ Do you see any cracks? Look again, and once again, and your gaze will return embarrassed and exhausted. Indeed, we have beautified the nearer sky with stars and have made them means of pelting the shayateen. We have prepared for them the punishment of the blaze. وَلِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ As for those who disbelieve in their Rabb, عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمْ Their punishment shall be the hellfire. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ That is an evil place to return to. صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ Verily, Allah has spoken the truth.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Beautifully done there, Khadija. Now, inshallah, when you're ready, if you'd like to give us the second recitation, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن الرحيم إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن ما بينهما الرحمن
رب السماوات والأرض
يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله beautifully done there Khadija. Do you practice with your sister?
Sometimes.
Yeah, because you both have very strong mujawwad style. Alhamdulillah. Very very well done Khadija. Now your speech for today inshallah. What's the topic you've chosen?
Don't sleep before you hear me out.
Okay, I won't, inshallah. No problem, inshallah. Khadija, when you're ready, inshallah, you can begin your speech as well.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد. My dear respected brothers, sisters, hosts, honorable judges, and fellow audience, I'm going to start with the greetings of Islam and the way of Nabi Kareem, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Muslims of 2016, why are we so heedless? Why are we so neglectful? How can we possibly sleep at night when we haven't fulfilled our responsibilities? Are we fooling ourselves? We do not offer our prayers. We don't recite Quran. We don't do the dhikr of Allah. We disobey him 24/7. Yet, he still loves you, he feeds you, gives you shelter, gives you money. How can we have boldness, the nerve to even sleep at night without obeying Allah's commands? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith mentioned in Sahih Muslim, أَلَّا يَنَامَ وَلَوْ عَلَى وَجَهِهِ أَرْضِ خَصَبَ. If a person wants to improve his relationship, his condition, his spiritual state, he must do four things before he goes to sleep. Number one, he must make sure that he has resolved any arguments or conflicts with anyone. And this is something very important in our ummah today. There's no unity. We always have to be divided. What does Allah say in Surah Hujurat, verse 10? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم.
The believers are all one, so create harmony between them. May Allah give us all unity. Everyone say Ameen. Number two.
ولا بقي عليه فرض من فرائض الله.
You must make sure you have fulfilled all the obligations that are owed to Allah. If you haven't prayed your salah, how can you possibly go sleep?
Number three. حتى يتوب من ذنوبه التي سلفت منه.
You can't sleep until you have taken a moment out and privately asked Allah for repentance. What does Allah say in Surah Tahrim, verse 8?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا.
Repent to Allah with a sincere tawbah, with a proper tawbah. And lastly, number four.
حتى يكتب وصية صحيحة.
You must make sure that all major arrangements have been made, just in case you don't wake up the next morning. This is what is required to have a good relationship with Allah, to have a strong relationship with Allah. It's not something simple. It's not something easy. Sacrifices must be made in order to gain that status with Allah. We must prepare ourselves to meet our Creator again. What does Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in a hadith narrated in Tirmidhi?
Al-kayyisu man dana nafsah wa amila lima ba'da al-mawt.
You want to know the real intelligent person? It's not the riches of businessmen, not the best of football players, not the most famous of celebrities. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the actual intelligent and clever person is that person who works and prepares himself for the hereafter. Subhanallah. Wallahi. Wallahi. It's not easy. It is difficult. But we must take that first step and Allah will do the rest. So are we all ready for this sacrifice? Everyone say, Insha'Allah.
Insha'Allah.
وما علينا إلا البلاغ.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah, beautifully done. They're very, very confident. SubhanAllah. Wow, you're only 9 years old, huh?
Allahu Akbar.
MashaAllah, very, very, very well done. Khadija, jazakallah khair for that, inshaAllah, if you'd like to take your seat now.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, that was 9-year-old Khadija Fatima Ali from London, MashaAllah. Beautifully done there. Now our next contestant is our youngest for the final, alhamdulillah. And if I can now call upon to the stage, 8-year-old Zainab Begum from London.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Zainab, how do you feel today?
Alhamdulillah, I'm fine.
Yeah, you know you're the youngest here today, don't you? You're not scared at all, are you?
No.
No, not at all. Alhamdulillah. Are you prepared? You've been preparing well?
Yes.
Confident?
Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah. Excellent. Alhamdulillah. Khair Zainab. When you're ready, inshallah, you can begin with your first recitation, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا والباقيات الصالحات خير عند ربك ثوابا خير عند ربك ثوابا وخير أملا ويوم نسير الجبال وترى الأرض بارزة وحشرناهم فلم نغادر منهم أحدا وعرضوا على ربك صفا لقد جئتمونا كما خلقناكم أول مرة بل زعمتم أن لن نجعل لكم موعدا
ووضع الكتاب فترى المجرمين مشفقين مما فيه ويقولون يا ويلتنا ما لهذا الكتاب لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها ووجدوا ما عملوا حاضرا ولا يظلم ربك أحدا صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Very very beautiful. Very very well done. Very soothing voice you've got.
It is, isn't it? That's why I was looking this way. I had to turn towards her just to watch how she's doing it. Subhanallah.
Very, very well done. Zainab, when you're ready, inshallah, you can give us the translation for that as well.
I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed shaitan. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Wealth and children are decoration of life of this world. And the everlasting, the good works, are better with your Lord in reward and best in hope. And the day which will cause the mountains to pass away, and you see the earth a level plain, and will gather them and not leave any of them behind. And they shall be brought before Lord in standing ranks. Now Allah will say, now certainly you have came to us as we created you at first, but you thought we had appointed no meetings for you. وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابِ And the book of deeds shall be placed. Then you'll see the criminals fearing from what is in it. And they will say, يَا وَيْلَتَنَا We are doomed. مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ What kind of book is this? It doesn't leave out a small nor a big sin unrecorded. وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا They will find the action present in front of them. And your Lord didn't oppress anyone. صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ Verily, Allah has spoken the truth.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Beautifully done there, Zainab. When you're ready, inshallah, you can give us the second recitation as well.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وهو الغفور الودود ذو العرش المجيد فعال لما يريد هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط سبحان الله بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسماء
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Beautifully done there, Zainab. Wow, you surprised me. You're only 8 years old, huh? MashaAllah, beautiful.
Sound like she's 8 years
no,
old.
No, she's got some good pair of lungs there for her. Alhamdulillah. Now, Zainab, your speech for today. What topic have you chosen?
The destroy of all pleasures.
The destroy, part two. Alhamdulillah, excellent. Okay, Zainab, inshallah, when you're ready, you can begin your speech as well, inshallah.
نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. My dear respected brothers, sisters, hosts, honorable judges, fellow audience, and the ones watching through the live transmission. I'm going to start with the greeting of Islam and the way Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaykum wa barakatuh.
If anyone is diagnosed with an illness or disease by the doctor and he says you only have 3 months to live, what happens? Watch how their character changes. Watch their life change from one angle to another. Watch how they repent, and it's good. But do you know what the saddest thing is? We wait for the doctor to tell us we are going to die, but he has no effect on us. When Allah mentions in the Quran that death will come to you 145 times, Allahu Akbar. Allah didn't care who you are, where you're from. Allah didn't care if you're strong. Allah didn't care what city you're from. Even if you're a prophet, he doesn't care. Even if you worship him for 100 years, he doesn't care. Why? Because Allah says in Surah Ar-Rahman, verse 26. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم كل من عليها فان. Everyone on this earth will perish. Everyone will die. No one's going to stay. Only Allah will remain forever. You have the greatest man ever who graced the surface of this world. Who was he? None other than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did death let him go? It is mentioned in Tirmidhi that Ali ibn Hussein says that we seen angels coming. Jibreel alayhi salam and Malakul Maut came together. Jibreel alayhi salam knocked on the door and says, Ya Rasulullah, hadha Malakul Maut yasta'din. O Messenger of Allah, the angel of death is asking for permission to come in. مَسْتَأْذَنَ عَلَىٰ آدَمِيٍّ قَبَلَكَ وَلَا بَعْدَكَ. He never asked permission before us. First man, he's asking for permission. Malakul Maut enters and says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَرْسَلَنِي إِلَيْكَ. Do what Allah has sent me to you if you permit very politely. I'll take your soul out. And if you decline, I respect your request. Jibreel alayhi salam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَاقَ إِلَى لِقَائِكَ. Your Allah is passionate to see you. Your Allah can't wait to meet you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at Malakul Maut and says, do what you have to do, and the soul of the greatest man ever in history is taken out. Did death let him go? Every day, that grave is calling out, أَنَا بَيْتُ الدُّودِ أَنَا بَيْتُ الظُّلْمَةِ أَنَا بَيْتُ الْوَحْدَةِ. I'm the home of worms. I'm the home of darkness. I'm the home of loneliness. Prepare yourself before you come to me. Everyone had to take account of the court of Allah. Oh people, the promise of Allah is true. What promise? What promise? Allah says in Surah Taha, verse 55. مِنْهَا خَلَقَنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. From dust you have been created, to dust you will return, and once again we will resurrect you. So my fellow audience, we don't know when our times are going to come to an end. You don't know, but tomorrow may be next in line. So repent to Allah, and Allah is always available. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith narrated in Tirmidhi. هُوَ يَقَبَلُ تَوْبَةَ الْعَبَدِ مَا لَمْ يُغَرْغِرُ. Before your final breath, Allah is going to be there. But after that, there's no forgiveness. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Wow, truly inspirational. SubhanAllah. Very, very well done. And you know, you were so confident.
So
Subhanallah.
Very, very confident, honestly. Like, to think you're just 8 years old, subhanallah. You could have taken part in the older group and probably won. To be honest, she was very, very good. Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah khair, Zainab. For that, inshallah, you can take your seat.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wow, subhanAllah, some truly inspirational stuff from 8-year-old Zainab Begum, our youngest contestant for today, alhamdulillah. Now we've come to the our final contestant now, alhamdulillah. And I'd like to call upon stage, also from London, 10-year-old Suraya Akhtar, if Suraya can come to the stage, inshallah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. Suraya, how are you feeling today?
الحمد لله.
Yeah. What do you think of everyone who's taken part?
ما شاء الله.
Yeah. They were good.
Good ones.
Yeah.
But you're ready, right?
Inshallah.
Is it exciting being in the final?
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you prepared well?
Yeah.
Inshallah. Excellent. Okay. Suraya, when you're ready. You can begin with your first recitation, inshallah, okay?
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. إن يوم الفصل ميقاتهم أجمعين يوم لا يغني مولى عن مولى شيئا ولا هم ينصرون إلا من رحم الله إنه هو العزيز الرحيم إن شجرة الزقوم طعام الأثيم كالمهل يغلي في البطون كغلي إلى سواء الجحيم ثم صبوا فوق رأسه من عذاب الحميم ذق إنك أنت العزيز الكريم إن هذا ما كنتم تمترون إن المتقين في مقام أمين صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله. Beautifully done, Suraya. When you're ready, inshallah, you can give us the translation.
أعوذ بالله من
Suraya, the translation.
I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed shaitan. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Indeed, the day of judgment has been fixed for all of them. The day when one companion will be of no benefit to another, neither shall they be assisted, but those on whom Allah has mercy. Allah is undoubtedly the mighty, the most merciful. Verily, the tree of Zaqqum shall be food for the sinful. It will be like residue of oil and reboil in the bellies. Khudu, grab him. Fa'tilu, then drag him. Ila sawa'il jahim. To the very midst of the blazing fire. Then pour the punishment of boiling water over his head. Taste. You are surely most honorable and esteemed. This is what you used to doubt.
إن المتقين في مقام أمين.
Verily those with taqwa shall be in a place of peace. صدق الله العظيم.
Verily Allah has spoken the truth.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Keep doing that with that smile, MashaAllah. Excellent. Now, Suraya, when you're ready, inshallah, you can give us your second recitation as well.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
يطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون بأكواب وأباريق وكأس من معين
لا يصدعون عن
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Get a few gulps of that in, inshaAllah. Very, very well done, alhamdulillah, Suraya. Now, your speech as well for today, what's the topic?
Allah doesn't need us at all.
Allah doesn't need us at all, MashaAllah. Excellent, alhamdulillah. You ready?
Yeah.
Yeah, inshaAllah. Suraya, when you're ready, inshaAllah, you can begin.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد, my dear respected brothers, sisters, hosts, honorable judges, and fellow audience, I'm going to start with the greetings of Islam and the way of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Do we think Allah really needs us? Allah doesn't need me. Allah doesn't need you. Allah doesn't need anyone. Allah is Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Aziz, Al-Jabbar, Al-Mutakabbir. Allah is free. He doesn't need anything or anyone. What does Allah say in Surah Fatir, verse 15?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله.
Oh people, you are all beggars to Allah.
والله هو الغني الحميد.
Allah is independent, most worthy of praise. People walking around with an attitude, I don't have to pray, I don't have to fast, or even worse, I have been fasting for 10 years now, Oh, I have been praying for 10 years now. How come Allah doesn't give me the things I want? What, you think Allah owes you something? You think Allah has to give something back? Once the Sahabas were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the hadith is mentioned in Sahih Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is addressing the Sahabas. Inni ara ma la taraun. I see what you do not see. Wa asma'u ma la tasma'un. And I hear what you do not hear. Atlatis sama. Prophet says the heaven has speaked. You know when something is overloaded, it begins to squeak? So the Prophet ﷺ said the seventh heaven is squeaking. The Sahabas asked, why is sky overloaded? Prophet replies, which is mentioned in Sahih Muslims. مَا فِي مَوْضِعٍ أَرْبَعُ أَصَابِحٍ. There is a room in all these heavens for four fingers, except there is an angel in prostration to Allah. Allahu Akbar. And you think Allah needs a loose change in the donation bucket? Allah doesn't care if you pray or you don't pray, if you believe or you don't believe. Allah says in Surah Kahf, verse 29, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر. If you want to believe, you can believe, and if you want to disbelieve, you go to that. But always know and always keep this in your mind. إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Indeed, Allah's punishment is deadly. Understand? Allah doesn't need you. You pray or you don't. You fast or you don't. You give zakah or you don't. Allah doesn't care. You make an effort or you don't. He doesn't care. You need him. He doesn't need you. You are in need of him. Salah doesn't need you. We need salah. Fasting doesn't need you. We need to fast. Zakah doesn't need us. We need zakah. Please understand, Allah doesn't need us whatsoever. Why? Because Allah says, if you turn away, Allah will replace you with others who will. Not be like you. So if you disobey him, he will replace you with those who will obey him. It's front of our eyes. Day by day, people are leaving the fold of Islam. Why? Because of our disobedience. Allah easily substitutes us with others. He doesn't need us. We are in need of him. So I make dua to Allah that he keeps us Muslims until Qiyamah. And I also make dua to Allah that he gives us all the tawfiq to act upon what has been said. Ameen. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ.
MashaAllah, 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 beautifully done there.
Allahu Akbar.
Sheikh Nasir, when was the last time you gave a speech like that?
I can't remember. I'm trying to copy this.
Yeah,
copy
definitely.
Copy speech, record it in my memory. Next time that's going to be my speech, inshallah.
SubhanAllah. Wow, wow, wow. What an end to the competition.
Amazing.
Today. Suraya.
MashaAllah.
JazakAllah khair. Beautifully done there.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. I think there must be something in that water. But no, very, very well done. Alhamdulillah, that was 10-year-old Suraya Akhtar from London. Wow, subhanAllah. We've come to the end of the episode, alhamdulillah, end of the final. And I think all of you, everyone who's been present here, and then obviously those of you who are watching from TV will agree that the competition has been awesome today. Each contestant has been absolutely awesome, very, very confident, and just... SubhanAllah, you know, you'd fail to understand or comprehend how they are so young, yet delivering something which, you know, like our Shaykh have said, that, you know, someone elder is finding it difficult, or someone actually professional, you know, someone who finds it difficult to give or deliver something like that. SubhanAllah. Now, Shaykh, obviously, we're coming to the very end of the show. One thing, for obviously, for the benefit of our people, sort of viewers as well, is that the announcement for the winner will not be given today. That was the announcement will actually be given on the 30th of April, which is the grand ceremony, alhamdulillah, the award ceremony, which will be at the London Muslim Center, where our chief guest, inshallah, on that day will be Sheikh Biladi, who is the Imam of Masjid al-Qiblatain. So everyone obviously is encouraged to obviously attend. Buy your tickets as well, inshallah. And for further information, you can go to qfactor.org.uk, inshallah. Now, Sheikh Fakhruddin, inshallah, if I can just come to you, just very few words, inshallah, just before we wrap up today. Were you amazed as much as I was?
SubhanAllah, truly and honestly, very amazing. I have no word to explain. No, nothing to explain, subhanAllah. Especially last few participants. Amazing. And topics, subhanAllah. Sometimes makes us cry. The way they presented and yeah, the wordings they used. Hadith and Quranic verses, subhanAllah. So I say to Allah that Allah accepts all these hard work. Allah accepts all these young people. And Allah really make them the honorable imam and shuyukh and shuyukha of the community.
Inshallah.
MashaAllah. Hufaz and qurra of the community.
Amen.
But I will add up one little point in here. As I said throughout quarterfinal, semifinal, and even last year's, that obviously you are all doing it for sake of Allah. And definitely you know that in your heart that Allah will reward you for every single hard work you have done, every letter you've recited in here and in home. Right, Allah will reward you, but for sake of competition, some people will go to first, second, third, and etc. But do not worry about this. Leave it on Allah. Rely on Allah. Right, if you don't go to first position, don't say anything. Say it is Allah's decision. We judges, we tried our best to be fair and honest as best as possible. But if Allah kept something for you, you will get it. Yes? So rely on Allah, pray to Allah. And one last thing I will share to you, that learning tajweed is not the end, as Sheikh said at the beginning. This is just the beginning. This is just the starter. When I finished my Sabah Ashara, my Ustad said the same thing. He said, Fakhrul Islam, this is just the starter for you. This is just begun for you. Next is learning. We went through the books and learning the lines in the books. But when it comes to practical field, that's the starting of learning. So if you learned tajweed, now you need to practice it. You need to teach others. And you need to keep practicing it every day so you don't forget those. So inshallah. And especially one thing you will focus, the lahne jali, major errors shouldn't happen. What we have realized today, a lot of dal, ta, sin, za, dal, these often happening. Yeah, so that shouldn't come to final. Yes, so inshallah, all of you in general, I will tell you, obviously I can't mention anyone's name, right? All of you in general, focus at these letters what I mentioned. Try, is this right? Try with your teacher, tell your teacher to give you feedback. Inshallah, Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah accept you all. May Allah accept your parents. May Allah accept your teachers. And may Allah accept us all. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And may Allah accept London and United Kingdom as the hub of Quran. Say Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen.
Ameen, Jazakumullah khair. Sheikh Fakhrul for that, inshallah. Sheikh Bukhari, inshallah, just a few comments.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah, salatu ala Rasulillah. First of all, let me complete the ayah that I started reading and made the mistake at the start. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ya ayyuhal muzammil qumil layla illa qalila. نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله.
My dear respected audience participants, respected elders and respected judges and very respected
Mashallah.
Presenter. MashaAllah. The way this program has been set, it's very significant and very honorable change in our Muslim community, Muslim Ummah. It's so wonderful to see somebody like yourself sitting there and knowing everything, MashaAllah, to start and how to introduce the participants and how to encourage them, how to give them the strength, the physical, mental, psychological, and emotional, and iman, the level of iman encouragement. It was so wonderful. And I've seen my honorable judges right and left. I've been looking in their results. How keen and how meticulous they were in their results. I am so proud of them, Wallahi al-Azim. I am so proud of you, the people, the participants, those who have participated. Such a wonderful recitations, such a wonderful speeches, such a great presentation, such an unparalleled confidence.
Subhanallah.
I congratulate you, congratulate your parents. MashaAllah, MashaAllah, MashaAllah. I can say with the confidence that this ummah is not devoid of its future. Allah. You are the future of this ummah. Jazakumullahu
ahsan al-jaza. Ameen.
Ameen. As my respected Sheikh has mentioned, the aghlat, the mistakes, minor and bigger mistakes. And there are hidden mistakes as well, al-khafi. And also the mistakes of waqf and i'ada. Tajweed completes, a tartil completes with tajweed and waqf. Waqf is stopping and starting again. So there have been mistakes. But all, my respected presenter, wallahi, it was so successful, so beautiful. So iman elevating, subhanallah al-azim. I congratulate the channelers. I congratulate my respected people, those who are organizer of this Q Factor. And I'm indebted to them, inshallah. Jazakumullah. My iman has gone very, very high. Subhanallah. Allah give you jaza al-khair.
Ameen.
Takbir.
Allahu
Takbir.
Allahu
Takbir.
Jazakumullah.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh, for those wonderful words. Sheikh Nasir.
Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. The shaykhs have said everything. You've kept me last without having anything to say. I didn't have anything to say from the beginning. Now, I don't have anything to say, but still I'm going to say a couple of things. MashaAllah, well done to all the participants, from number one to number eight. Each and every one of you were fantastic. Sure. All the participants from the beginning, quarterfinals, semifinals, finals, you all are winners. Regardless of whichever position you come in, it doesn't matter. Because you are the students of the Quran, according to the hadith of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَ. We are all winners. We are all winners. Along the way, some of us gain more reward, some of us less. But we are all winners. So we have to think and take from here that we all are winners, regardless of whichever position we come. One of the contestants here, I asked, when I came in, I'm not going to name, but are you going to be crying today after we give our decision? He goes, no. Oh, she goes, no. I'll say, Alhamdulillah. So that is great. You know, I wouldn't even said that. I would have said yes.
I'm going to cry.
Yeah, I'm going to cry. You know, but the strength of iman, the level of iman, the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that young lady, young girl, mashallah, it deserves appreciation.
Mashallah.
So the final thing I'll say, thanks to all the teachers, channelers, Q Factor, Global Aid, and parents, the effortless timing support given by parents, teachers, subhanallah, it's amazing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward each and every one of us and accept our time, effort for His pleasure and grant us the guidance and عِتْكُم مِّنَ النَّارِ, the Ameen. Freedom from fire of hell on the Ameen. Day of judgment. Ameen. And make dua for each and every one of us. And if we've done any mistake, please forgive us and see us with the eyes of mercy, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Nasir. Wow, subhanAllah, very, very well summed up by all of our judges here, alhamdulillah. Today has been a very mesmerizing, a very inspiration, and like the Sheikh said, a very iman boosting, uplifting final today, alhamdulillah. And each one of you, and this is what I'd like to say, you know, like Sheikh Nasir said, all of you are winners. True. And all of you are not just winners, but all of you have been accepted in the eyes of Allah. That's why you're here. You know, the fact that Allah has accepted you is the fact that you are here as well. So alhamdulillah, you know, may Allah accept your efforts, and may Allah accept that of your parents and, you know, your well wishes as well, alhamdulillah. But just as a parting notice, inshallah, just before we do finish off for today, the winners, inshallah, will be announced on the 30th of April at the London Muslim Centre, which is next to East London Masjid, on the 30th of April, where obviously that will be the award ceremony, where we have as our chief guest, inshallah, Sheikh Biladi, the Imam of Masjid Qiblatain. So for further information, again, inshallah, and to purchase your tickets, go to qfactor.org.uk. But inshallah, before we finish for today, I'd like to once again thank our contestants for coming and just inspiring us, alhamdulillah. I'd like to thank their parents, their families, their teachers who have come all the way to support them. And, you know, like our shuykh have been saying from the very beginning, you know, without your support, these kids wouldn't have got to this stage. So a very, very big thanks goes to all of you as well. And jazakallah khair to our beloved judges, obviously, for coming today and giving their nasiha and also, obviously, making the tough decision of marking, alhamdulillah. But inshallah, until, I guess, the 30th of April, when the announcement will be given, Do look after yourself, but do, inshallah, do watch the program tomorrow as well, where the, it will be the grand finale for the older years, inshallah, for the teen years. But until then, inshallah, do look after yourself. And inshallah, I guess, take care of yourself. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
يا أمتي القرآن حبل نجاتنا فتمسكي بعراه كي لا نغرق.